Shabbat Shalom, and Senbet Salam, fellow Rastafari. This is Wenda Malanso. Today is November 24th, and we were just watching a video presentation of Wendem Yadon on Rastafari sabbatical, and we just felt like putting out random information concerning Rastafari and Ethiopia. And well, basically we just feel that in some way or another this may potentially be of use to Rastafari or anyone in the common struggle. Now, this is not going to be biblical study or anything like that, but it goes to show how much information one can obtain from just looking up one word on the, and this is to reference the material on the Oxford English Dictionary, original publication 1933. The version that we are referencing is a republication of 1966, and basically just a few minutes in the library. And we were only focusing on the word Ethiopia, but you know, a lot of very significant words actually begin with the same root as Ethiopia. So let us just kind of go through this really fast. Etiolate, to etiolate. What is to etiolate? Of dialectical origin, to render pale, of colorless, open parentheses, plants, close parentheses, by excluding the light from it. And Darwin himself notes this. Grow in darkness, open parentheses, albino plants, close parentheses. Second definition for this is to give a pale or sickly hue, of sickly hue, to human being or skin, to become white or whiter, to blanch by exclusion of sunlight. Now we have this other word, Ethiopoeia, Ethiopoeia. We're not sure, we doubt that that is the exact pronunciation, but it is spelled Ethiopoeia. Character, representation, delineation of character. And then we have open parentheses, ret, close parentheses, that is R-H-E-T. Now we have Ethiopoetic, intended to show or to represent character or manners. Now we have ethos, E-T-H-O-S, a person's nature or character, disposition, a person's nature or character or disposition. Also the genius of a system, you know, the whole work, the masterwork, the mastermind of a fully functional system. Now we have eth or eth, eth equals formation, open parentheses, of all natures, close parentheses. And now we have Ethiop, to burn, and plus faith. So Ethiop is kind of like to burn plus faith, and that is burnt faith. Now if we open parentheses, and this is quoting, sunburnt, later changed to sunburnt, question mark, we're not too sure what that's all about, but there might be some kind of changing of definition. It could have been something like once used as sunburnt and now referred to as burnt faces. And Rastafari, we have a pretty good idea of why that may be the case. If once, well, it turns out we are gonna actually reference scripture More precisely, the book of Revelation and chapter 1, and book of Revelations chapter 1, verse 16. And he had in his right hand seven stars, and out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, and his countenance was as the sun shineth in his strength. Now, just making that clear connection. So, that might very well be the reason from going either from burnt faces to sunburnt or from sunburnt to burnt faces. Regardless, it's kind of clear, it's kind of obvious, the whole connection there. Now, let us continue. We have here a ethymologizing or etymologizing corruption of a foreign ethnic name. So this is kind of like confessing to the fact that Ethiop is kind of a corruption of an ethnic foreign name. So let us continue. Now we are referencing Homer. And Homer, in fact, mentions Ethiopians, people dwelling in the far east and in the far west. In later Greek, name was applied to inhabitants of Africa, mainly south of Egypt, but also to peoples swarthy. We didn't look that up. It is SWARTHY, complexion in other parts of the world, usually a person, black skin, a blackamoor. Now, okay, this kind of makes sense why we even felt the need to go with this. The whole, Homer mentions Ethiopians, people dwelling in the far east and far west, which that in itself is very important to take note and to do further research. But then we have in the later Greek, name was applied to inhabitants of Africa, mainly south of Egypt, but also to peoples swarthy complexion in other parts of the world, usually a person, black skin, or blackamoor. Now we have phrase, and these are kind of we don't know what to say. This is the ways in which the word Ethiop were often used in the days of old to wash an Ethiop white, to attempt the impossible. Yeah, so now this is interesting in itself. There is reference to the Ethiopian line, open parentheses, Milton, close parentheses, the equator. That makes a lot of sense. Now, priest and theoretical, Ethesian, excuse that, Ethesian or Ethesian. And now, if we open parentheses, sociology plus judgment plus economics. So now we're getting into a better understanding of Willie Lynchism and stuff like that. We'll try to do like a little summary, but let us conclude this. Ethicize or ethicize, to discuss ethics, speak right morals. Speak or write morals or moralize, make ethical, invest with ethical element. Now, we'll do a little summary shortly. 1667, by some thought true paradise, and this is referencing Ethiopia, under the Ethiop line by Nellis Head Hugh of Ethiop. And now we have black. So basically, we have some references to the Ethiop or Ethiopic equator and true paradise. We have Ethiopians as mainly Africans south of Egypt, dwelling in the Far East, Far West. I mean, a lot of interesting material. Just in a few minutes of just copying Oxford English Dictionary, republished 1961. Now let us continue. 1597, Gerard Herbel, the Ethiopian apple. That's kind of interesting. We didn't do further research. Now we have epithet, that is EPITHET, open parentheses, regions of the earth's surface, close parentheses. Now we have, that's interesting too. Now we have 1727, Defoe's magic, 1840, 63. I guess that is kind of like referencing like a book or something. Ethiopians of Arabia Felix, which they call the South, and who thought Arabians are called Ethiopians in scripture. Sapiens, and we believe that they were trying to do some mention of only one race, the Homo sapiens, but we just kind of made a side note and we just wrote in sapiens, sapiens, because it kind of, it's kind of one and the same, but we're not too well informed on that, so it's just an assumption. Now we have to conclude 1659, Hammond on PS IXXII 9 annotation 350, the Ethiopic Sea. But I guess what we wanted to really briefly summarize is the whole foreigners coming to Ethiopia and developing what is recognized as ethics. So what is it? It is barbarians, outsiders, studying the behavior of Ethiopians, and that is actually what is all the ethics and all kinds of different studies like that. But we just wanted to make the link that, as His Imperial Majesty says, that anyone that takes time to kind of like notice the lives of others, that individual is revealing characteristics of a lazy person. And so anyone that just takes the time to notice, whether it be an achievement or a failure on the part of another individual, that person noticing these things is showing his characteristics of a lazy person. So now we have sojourners coming into the lands of Ethiopia and studying moral and ethical behavior and good behavior, and them thinking themselves to be superior, believing that their mission on earth is complete, that they have reached the ultimate perfection. That actually leaves space and room and time to study other individuals as if they themselves cannot have been already perfected and cannot perfect themselves any further. And so they take the time to study other peoples, in this case Ethiopians, and surely enough they add a little economic twist, and with that you have white supremacy and the idea of superiority, because now you notice the mistakes of another people and you find a way in which to capitalize, in this case literally, and thus the history up till now. And so basically, yeah, it turns out that this has much relevance to the video we were actually watching, and so we give thanks to Wyndham Yadom for putting out like so much great material, and we give thanks to all Ras Tefari and anyone that you know that supports the Lion of the Tribe of Judah Society, and sure we'll go ahead and mention it, and those that make Rastafari Fellowship YouTube channel possible, and so we give thanks to all. Shalom Ras Tefari.